What we're doing today is we are releasing the policy document on the Black Industrialist Program as it has now been approved by Cabinet. And then also there is a program guidelines for the incentive scheme for the Black Industrialist Program that will be administered by the DTI. It's only one component of the Black Industrialist Program. Let me start off by saying that characterize how does the program fit in. I think that if we look at the economic challenges that we're facing as a country, with all the news that has come out in the last few days, I'm thinking in particular of the announcements by Anglo-American and others, what we are confronting is some very serious headwinds striking right at the heart of the productive sector of the South African economy. And our vulnerability lies in the fact that we have been historically and still are to a very large extent a country that earns its foreign exchange and its income from the production and export of primary mineral commodities. And the fact of the matter is that globally there is now a very serious fall in the prices of those structural of those mining commodities. So for example, the price of platinum is now one-third down on what it was in 2012 at the height of the commodity super cycle. Gold is about half, and iron ore is about a quarter of what it was then. That is the sort of harsh, stark reality that's confronting our country. And so what we've been saying for a long time, and this has been the work of the Industrial Policy Action Plan, is that the only future for us, and this is also the view of the African continent, move up the value chain and industrialize. Now, if we're going to do that, we've got to do it in a way that also promotes economic inclusion, because that's the other big challenge in this economy, that we've got still, after 21 years of democracy, we still have an economy which is dominated by a minority of the population, and that's particularly stark in the manufacturing sector. That's the harsh truth, that's the reality. And so I think that we have decided that we wouldn't be able to industrialize unless we simultaneously produce economic inclusion, and we won't be able to promote economic inclusion on a sustainable basis unless those people are also involved in the industrial economy of this country. So I think that's the genesis of the Black Industrialist Policy, and it's been discussed for quite a while. So what we've been saying is that this is going to be one of the significant drivers, as we see it, of the industrialization strategy. But also I think we see this as a potential game changer in the way in which black economic empowerment has unfolded in South Africa. Already with the new codes and the work that's been done there, we've been trying to prioritize those parts of the codes that could contribute to the emergence of actual business people, for example, in supplier development, skills development and stuff like that. We've been trying to move in this direction, and this is a particular focused program that is looking to promote a subcategory, if you want, of empowered people. Those are people that are involved in the industrial sector, so black industrialists. Now, the document is quite tight on a few things. The program is going to provide dedicated financial support, access to markets, and also other kinds of support as we unfold it. But we want to make sure that we're targeting the right kind of people. So the definition of black industrialist is quite tight. And it says a black industrialist is a juristic person that includes cooperatives incorporated in terms of the Companies Act that is owned by black South Africans as defined in the Broad-Based Black Economic Empowerment Act, who creates and owns value-added industrial capacity and provides long-term strategic and operational leadership to a business. A black industrialist can also be a natural person. And then it talks about some characteristics. A black industrialist must provide strategic and operational leadership to a business with a high level of ownership, more than 50%, and or exercising control over that business. They must be identifying opportunities and developing the business to take advantage of the opportunities, in other words, be entrepreneurial. must take personal risk in the business, must be personally involved in the business, doing business in the manufacturing sector, and then it's identifies, I'll come to those in a minute, makes a long-term commitment to the business in the as a medium or long-term investor. You're not just a shareholder in something, a passive shareholder, you're actually actively involved. While there's a desire to support entities with significant and dominant black ownership and control, it's accepted that there may be a need to include other shareholders to attract relevant skills, finance, and opportunities. Really what we're trying to do is target entrants, but also existing players, and try to provide support that enables them to emerge as more significant industrial players in the economy. The sectors, well, they're all defined. They're all pretty much recognizable from the IPAP, the blue economy or oceans economy, oil and gas, clean technology and energy, mineral beneficiation, aerospace, industrial infrastructure, ICT, agro-processing, clothing and textiles, leather and footwear, pulp, paper, furniture, chemicals, nuclear, manufactured-related logistics, sectors designated for localization. These can be reviewed from time to time, but I think you'll see that they're all the IPAP sectors. Then what we're doing is we're saying we'll provide financial support. How's this going to work? Well, we are asking all parts of government that are responsible for development finance institutions or provide incentive programs to dedicate a particular portion of their activities to support the Black Industrialist Program. Then we are saying that we will create a forum of effectively, and says, officials responsible for funding decisions in participating DFIs. It won't be politicians, it'll be officials who take funding decisions from the participating DFIs. They will be gathered into a forum, and that forum will look at applications. Those applications will come in, and they will pick the best of the applications to support them according to the mandate of the institution concerned. So there's no way the forum is going to override the funding decisions of, let's say, the Industrial Development Corporation or anybody else that's involved. The document says the forum will play an information sharing and coordinating role, which will include pre-assessment of the Black Industrialist applications. It will undertake pre-assessment of potential projects to be supported as part of the Black Industrialist Program. But then it goes on, as I said already, responsibility for formal approval of finance or incentives remains subject to the internal processes of the DFIs or the funding institutions concerned. So it's a clearinghouse where we say that, for example, as we've been trying to say before, if you apply for a DTI incentive, which would be an incentive, you may also need a capital injection from the IDC or from somebody else. How can we combine resources and say this one looks like one of the best? Let's give it a quality attention that comes from a multiplicity of sources. There's also a similar forum that will be established with the state-owned companies about opportunities for the Black Industrialists to participate in the supply chain of those. So what we're looking at is, it can be defined that the Black Industrialists may need mentoring, may need access to some kind of incubation, they may need support in export market promotion or whatever it may be. Need can also be met through the institutions that come together in that forum. The ministers that are involved in the, to whom the DFIs report, will meet from time to time to oversee the general work of the forums, but they will not be involved in the direct decisions of who's who in the zoo. I think if we can say, you know, industrial policy is sometimes seen as picking winners, I think this one is trying to get the winners to apply and then let's work with the winners. I think that's really what it is. In the different ways that are possible. We're also announcing that there will be a Black Industrialists scheme. We are one of the Malebu here in charge of the incentives. We are one of the players, and I'll tell you who else has made commitments in a second. Are we one of the players? And so we're also today announcing the Black Industrialist Scheme, and this will offer a cost-sharing grant ranging from 30 to 50% for approved entities with a maximum of 50 million. And the quantum of the grant will depend on the level of black ownership, management control, the projects, and so on and so forth. And it will be to support capital investment, feasible studies towards a bankable business plan, post-investment support or business development services. So that is one of the contributions that's already there. What has happened is that we have been, already we've seen a number of entities that have made announcements. So let me just say the ones that we're aware of up to now. Minister Patel announced that the Industrial Development Corporation would make available 23 billion over the next 5 years, starting with 3 billion rand in the 2015-16 financial year. That one, that announcement's already been made. The Land Bank has announced 3 billion. The Small Enterprise Finance Agency, 100 million. The Development Bank of Southern Africa, 2 billion. The KZN Growth Fund, 100 million. Those are ones that we are aware of up to now. And I think that, in other words, what we're saying is that now with the adoption of the strategy as it's gone through Cabinet and the work that's been done, this program will now start to operate. We will start to receive the applications. I think that we have, in addition to the for the DTI incentive, in addition to the just the guidelines, we also have the application or assessment form that's also available now. I'm sure these things will be on the DTI website, as will the policy, indeed, for people to get further information. So that's essentially what we're doing today. I think that's a summary of what's here, and I trust that you will be able to get the strategy document together with the guidelines for the DTI incentive. Thanks very much.